Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
How are you all? I'm also fine and happy to listen that you're very excited for the learning. Great, great, good job. Okay, so everybody, for learning, we use different resources, right? Do you use YouTube?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you use Play Store to download some learning resources?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, great. So there is one thing which we require to access YouTube and Play Store and many other applications.
Yes, ma'am.
Can you name that?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Amir.
Yes, ma'am. We require Gmail account.
Absolutely right. Very good. So we require Gmail account to access YouTube, Play Store, and many other applications. Right, everybody?
Yes, ma'am.
So today we are going to learn about how to not only learn, we are going to create our Gmail accounts. Okay. And we will also learn about the importance of keeping our passwords, Gmail passwords, safe. Alright, everybody?
Yes, ma'am.
So, how many of you have your email accounts? Wow, everybody has the email accounts. Wonderful, wonderful. That's great. Okay, what do you understand by Gmail? You all have your email account, it must be on Gmail only, right?
After my understanding, the meaning of Gmail account is the way of conversation.
Okay, the meaning of Gmail account is way of conversation. Very well tried. Is there anybody else who has different answer? Yes, Ravi.
As per my understanding, Gmail means like Google Mail.
Uh-huh.
Like we are going to create an account for sending and receiving the mails.
Very nice. So Gmail accounts are used for sending and receiving emails, right? And what is the difference between emails and normal messages which we send on WhatsApp? Why do we use emails?
According to my understanding, I think Gmail and
email. Gmail. It is not Gmail, it's Gmail.
Gmail and email. Like a WhatsApp message, informal way.
Informal or formal?
Informal.
Informal. Okay.
And email will send the message formal way.
In the formal way. Very good. So emails are used for formal communication, everybody. I hope you remember the discussion which we had about formal and informal. Can somebody share what is formal and what is informal? Yes, Aditi.
Okay, when we talk someone, so like our friends, so we use hi, hello. And when we use a professional man, like our teachers, so when we use hello, good morning sir, good morning ma'am.
Yes, very good. So these are known as formal and informal greetings which she shared. Right? Now we are going to talk about formal and informal email IDs. Okay, I am going to write some email IDs here and you need to share whether these email IDs are formal or informal. Okay?
Yes,
ma'am. So my first email ID. So if my email ID is formal, then you all can stand. If my email ID is informal, then you all can keep on sitting. Okay? So my first email ID is... Is it formal or informal? You need to either sit or stand. So three people are standing. Simi, can you please share why you're standing?
Because I think this email ID is formal.
Formal. And why do you think that it is formal? Yeah,
because I know my friend Ravi, he is a rock star.
Hmm. Oh, your friend Ravi is rock star?
Yes.
Great. Okay, what about others? What do you think? As many people are sitting. Yes, please.
Yes, ma'am. It email ID is not formal because in formal email ID we have to include some numbers, some symbols and some capital letter and a small letter.
Okay, is it compulsory that we have to use numbers and symbols in email ID?
No. It is okay. My opinion, ma'am.
Thank you so much for sharing that. Very well, right? What about others? Those who were sitting. Yes, Rajendra. You are sitting, that means it is informal. Why is it informal?
Yes, the email ID is informal because we are using the offered. Means not funny word. We can say funny word. Rock star Ravi. Means we cannot use any word which make which impact negatively in our ID.
Okay. Yes. So you mean to say that this ID is informal because It is not containing our full name, can we say?
Yes.
And it is little funny also, Rockstar Ravi.
Yes.
For him, his friend is actual Rockstar, but there are many people who are not Rockstar, but still they keep their names like Rockstar Ravi, right? And in formal places, can we keep such names if we are working somewhere?
No.
No, we cannot keep, right? Okay, next one. Okay, many people, everybody is standing. Let's listen to Nidhi. Nidhi, why do you think that it is formal?
Because you are use full name and you did not use and like Papa Ki Pari and that thing. So I like this is a formal way.
Formal way.
Yes.
Yes. So here my full name is there and no extra word like Papa Ki Pari. Yes, it is also informal. Very nice example of informal email ID. Right. So my name is containing my first name and the last name. My email is containing first name and last name. This is why it is formal. Very good, everybody. Please sit down and please clap for yourself, everyone. Nice. Now, when we create, now here, you all share that you all already have your email accounts. But now we will be having many tasks in FEA for which we are going to use our email IDs, right? You already have your email IDs, but there must be some email IDs which might be informal.
Yes, yes, yes.
Do you have formal IDs only or informal also? So this is why we are going to create one formal IDs for which the format will be your first name dot, it is a dot here, dot last name dot your FEA ID at the rate gmail.com. Okay, everybody. So we are going to create our email IDs. Not right now, after some time we will be creating, and the format of your email ID will be the same.
Okay.
Okay?
I have a question, ma'am.
Yes, please.
So why we are using only this format?
Very nice question. So we are using this format only because there can be many other, let's say I have to create my email ID, there can be many other Deepa Singh also.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Our country, our world is a huge word. So this is why when we create email ID with the same name, then sometimes it doesn't accept. So what we are going to do, we are going to make our email IDs unique by using some dots and by using FEA ID. And FEA ID cannot be same for everybody.
Yeah.
After creating your email IDs, we also have to create passwords. Do you all know about password?
Yes.
Now, why is it required to use passwords in Gmail accounts? Nandini, why do we require passwords?
Password is very important because any person open your IDs. Because any person open your IDs.
Yes, very good. So passwords are important because this email ID, the email IDs which we use it for formal communication, for sending or receiving some important documents. Yes. And if we do not keep our passwords safe, then our IDs can be misused by somebody.
Yes.
This is why we have to use our passwords. We have to first use passwords, and that too, our password should be strong.
Yes.
Like we have locks for our house.
Yes.
Do you select a weak lock for your house or strong? And do you give the key of the lock to everybody? Your friends or neighbors? No. So we just like we give the key of the lock of our house to any trusted person of our house. Similarly, we can share. So it is also optional. You may not share also. However, if you feel that you may forget your password, you may share the password with any of the most trusted person of your family.
Yes.
Okay. Now let's see some examples of weak password and strong password. Okay.
Yes.
If I write my password 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, will it be strong password or weak password?
No.
Are you sure?
Yes.
And if I write my phone number here, will it be weak or strong? It has many digits, many numbers here.
I listen to you, Prakash.
Yes, Prakash.
It's a weak password because everyone know our mobile number. So we can try by mobile number. So it's not a strong password.
Strong password. Absolutely right. It is also the weak password. Let me write another one now. Is it weak or strong?
Strong
password.
And why do you think that it is strong password?
Strong password because it is used by some symbols, some letters and some digits.
Absolutely right. So it is the combination of some symbols, letters and digits. If anybody want to guess our passwords, they will not be able to guess it, right?
Yes.
So we need to include, first of all, whenever you are going to create your password, set the password for your email IDs. So first one is, you have to use both uppercase and lowercase. What is uppercase and lowercase? Uppercase is capital letter and lowercase means small letter. So whenever you are going to set your password, you need to use capital letters, you need to use small letters, symbols and some numbers. Okay, these three things should be there, and your password should be of minimum 8 characters. Whether you are using symbol, letters or digits, it should be minimum 8. After that, you can even have more than 8 characters. Okay, everyone?
Okay.
So let me give some examples. You may even what kind of passwords we can create. You can write your first name of your grandmother. Okay?
Yes.
Grandmother's first name. Can anybody guess your grandmother's first name?
No.
With that, you can write your date of birth. Right?
Yes.
And you can add any symbol. Like this, you can make some strong password. Okay, everybody?
Yes.
I hope it is clear.
Yes.
Great. Now, are you ready to create your email accounts?
Yes.
So, for that, first we need to understand the process, process of creating email accounts. And that process is given in the audio video, everyone. So, we have two ABs. First one, AB1 is in Hindi. AB1 is in Hindi. And AB2 is in English. Those who are comfortable in English, they can open AB2 and watch the process of creating email accounts. And those who are comfortable with Hindi, they can watch AB1. Okay, everyone? And after watching the video, please do not close the video. You can pause and minimize the video. And you can open Google Chrome after that and follow the steps which are shared in the email ID. Alright, everybody?
Yes.
Is it clear?
Yes.
Are we all set?
Yes.
Okay. So, laptop pop, let's instruct them to move to the